If you're looking for a network-wide solution for ad blocking and reducing the amount of tracking online, AdGuard Home is a free and open source solution that you can use. The software is open source and can be self-hosted on an inexpensive device to both buy and run, such as the Raspberry Pi. Aside from ad and tracker blocking, AdGuard Home also has some other perks, such as being able to block malicious websites and give parents control over their devices connected to the network and what content is accessible. You may be thinking, well, can't I just run an ad blocker in my browser? And the answer is yes, but being able to do this at the DNS level across your whole network means that all of your devices won't see ads, even if they can't run an ad blocker, and you can free up some system resources as you don't need to run ad blocking software or apps on all of your devices individually. AdGuard Home isn't the only piece of software that does this, and Pi-hole is another option that I covered a few years ago, but I wanted to share AdGuard Home as I thought it is a handy piece of software that people may be able to benefit from. The process of getting up and running with AdGuard Home is pretty straightforward, as an automated install script will do most of the heavy lifting that would otherwise need to be done with a manual installation. This process should work with most Mac and Linux systems, and I'll be using a Raspberry Pi running Raspbian Lite for this tutorial, so I'll be referring to that a few times throughout. I'll also be using SSH, as this allows me to copy and paste any commands over that are needed, and it allows me to do any configuration directly from my computer over the network. So let's get started, and we will open a terminal and enter the following command. This command shouldn't take too long to run, and it will let you know when AdGuard Home has finished installing and is up and running. Within the terminal, you'll see some IP addresses to browse to in a web browser, and this will allow us to finish the configuration. So I'm doing the configuration from my computer, I'll be using the third IP address, but if you're doing this all directly on your Raspberry Pi, you can browse to http://127.0.0.1:3000. I really like the user interface of AdGuard Home, and we can see this immediately as we browse to the initial setup screen. Pi-hole, which I mentioned earlier, does let you have a bit more hands-on with the configuration and network side of things, but I think the interface of AdGuard Home is more user-friendly and pretty. Going through the setup, the settings on the initial page can be left as is, this will allow you to be able to utilize AdGuard Home regardless of whether you use Ethernet or Wi-Fi, but you can limit it to a specific network connection if you wish. It's also worth noting the instruction at the bottom of this page to set a static IP address for the device hosting AdGuard Home, in this case my Raspberry Pi. This can be done in the settings of your network router, but I shall not be going into this specifically as the method for doing this can drastically vary depending on who makes your router. You can also set your IP to static on the Pi itself, and the Pi Hut has a useful guide on how to do this, but I would recommend setting the static IP directly from the router if possible, as this will mitigate any network conflicts in the future as your router typically handles the assigning of IP addresses on the network. On the next page, we can set a username and password to access the AdGuard Home admin interface, and these are separate credentials to the user of the Raspberry Pi itself and are just used to access the AdGuard Home admin panel. Now, of course, to actually make use of AdGuard Home, we need to configure the devices on our network to use the Raspberry Pi as its DNS server. This page does have instructions for various types of devices, and I also have a tutorial on how to change your DNS server settings, which you can check out for more information. The best way to do this will be to change the settings on your router, as this means that all the devices connected to your network will use AdGuard Home running on the Raspberry Pi as its DNS server. But you can configure DNS settings on individual devices if you wish to have more control. When changing your DNS settings, make sure to use the address of your Raspberry Pi, which usually starts with 192.168, as your primary DNS server. This will ensure that all the DNS requests go through the AdGuard Home software. That's all the configuration out of the way, now we can take a look at the dashboard. I'll briefly be talking through the different sections of the dashboard, but there is quite a lot, so I won't be going into all of it in explicit detail. The dashboard is accessed by browsing to the IP address of your Raspberry Pi within the web browser. You can then log in with the credentials that you set earlier, and when logged in, you'll be able to see the statistics for what AdGuard Home has been up to, as well as what has been blocked and other network information, and this will begin to populate as more devices send DNS requests. Useful features on this page allow you to block specific clients by their IP address, as well as look at popular queries and blocked domains. Some domains have a green eye icon, which can be used to easily identify that specific domain to give you a better idea of the traffic on your network. There's not too much else on this page aside from the Disable Protection button at the top of the page, and if you're experiencing issues, it may be worth clicking this button when you're troubleshooting. Out of the box, most of the settings should be fine for most users, but you can tweak them to adjust what gets blocked, as well as additional filter lists and enable additional functionality such as DNS encryption. And using AdGuard Home as your DHCP server and client-specific settings such as blocking specific services on a specific device. The general settings are where you are able to make quick adjustments to your network. These allow you to enable additional blocking features, as well as enable safe search across all devices, and allow you to adjust logging and statistics by AdGuard. The DNS settings will let you set which DNS server AdGuard will use, and by default this is set up to use Quad9, but you can change it to any provider that you wish. And on this page you can also adjust how AdGuard Home will behave when it needs to block a connection. But these settings should be fine by default for most users, but you can tinker if you wish. The encryption and DHCP pages are more advanced, and you probably don't need to use these unless you already know that you'll need them. These are nice features to have included, but will require some additional configuration to get up and running, and you'll need to, in the case of encryption settings, set up a wildcard SSL certificate. The client settings page, however, you may find yourself using, and this page allows you to block services for specific devices, versus blocking them across your whole network, as well as override any global settings that apply to all devices. This could be handy if you wish to block someone's access to YouTube, for example, or wish to use a different upstream DNS provider, such as Cloudflare. Filters are another menu option that is present in the administration interface, and these filters let us control any blocking as well as allowing through any websites, even if they are on a block list. The DNS block lists are large lists of websites that people have created, and these are used by ad blockers to block them. By default, AdGuard uses its own block list, but you can add additional ones or even add your own. Allow lists are the opposite of these, and if you find something being blocked by a list, you can use an allow list to bypass the block list. You're also able to easily block predefined online services with a simple toggle, and this is good if you want to be able to quickly block access to a social network, game servers, or video streaming sites. There are a couple of advanced options here as well, and these will allow you to rewrite DNS requests as well as manually enter your own custom filtering rules. I won't go into these now, but they're quite nice features to have in case you need them in the future. And finally, the final page across the menu bar is the query log, and this is a log of everything that AdGuard Home gets up to and can be used to see what's being blocked and how long AdGuard Home is taking to perform DNS resolutions. This page allows you to also block domains if you see something which you think shouldn't be getting through. That's all there really is to AdGuard Home. It's surprisingly straightforward to get set up and running, and most things should be set up out of the box for how most users will be using it. I like how AdGuard Home presents itself in an approachable way, but still has some quite powerful features and options available for advanced users, and even further configuration can be done from the command line. That's been how to set up an ad blocker and filter across your entire network, allowing you to free up resources on your individual systems and keep any junk traffic out of your network. If you found this tutorial helpful, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.